You may have wondered why you're collecting all this data on temperature and relative humidity. The answer is that both temperature and relative humidity, or RH, affect the preservation of objects in your collection. So it's important to have a good understanding of your facility's climate to help you make good decisions for your collection. Environmental monitoring identifies current conditions and provides a record of past conditions, which can be used to predict conditions in the future. By keeping records on temperature and RH in your facility, you have the data readily available if you need to seek advice on climate control. These records also become essential when applying to various heritage programs that require evidence of your facility's conditions. Now that you know why you are monitoring your environment, how do you do this? There are three steps. 1. Gather the data using a recording device. 2. Review the data and interpret what it means for your facility. 3. Maintain the equipment used to gather the data to ensure the data is reliable. To understand your collection's environment, a combination of spot reading and recording devices can be used. Spot reading devices allow you to take a quick reading of current conditions. Recording devices automatically record many readings and can capture rapid changes that may last only a few minutes, as well as long-term trends over many months. Monitoring includes making note of unusual circumstances that have affected temperature and RH, such as power failures or scheduled maintenance events, so that you or others can recall these abnormalities when reviewing the data. It is important to regularly upload data from your data loggers or change your hygrothermographs paper. And it's useful to archive these records. But beyond this, you must review your data to understand your institution's climate and how it affects your collection. Once you have collected the data and reviewed it, you will have reliable evidence of the conditions your collection experiences. You may discover that your environmental conditions are entirely appropriate for your collection, or you may discover that you need to make adjustments for specific objects or collections. Here are some things that you should be looking for. RH that is consistently too high, above 75% over time, provides the right conditions for mold growth. And for metals to corrode. RH that is above or below a very specific level can cause damage to some objects. As an example, these glass beads sweat when RH rises above 55% and crizzle when RH drops below 40%. RH fluctuations can cause warping and cracking in vulnerable objects, such as paintings. Some materials, especially those in archival collections, deteriorate faster as RH gets higher. And some materials deteriorate faster as temperature gets higher. For some materials, like polyurethane foam and magnetic media, room temperature could be considered too high. In reviewing the data, you may detect instances of incorrect RH and temperature for specific objects or collections in your care. This allows you to respond appropriately to protect your collection. Remember that monitoring your environment is an ongoing procedure, and it is important that your equipment produces reliable information. Maintenance of equipment ensures that it will continue to function properly. In general, this means ensuring that batteries are replaced or the device is recharged regularly, and that instruments are calibrated periodically so that the measured values accurately reflect actual conditions. Let's summarize. Reliable monitoring of your facility's climate requires three steps. 1. Gather the data using a recording device. 2. Review and interpret the data. And 3. Maintain the equipment so that the data is reliable. This will allow you to provide records of your conditions to agencies that require them for loans, certification processes, or grants, and they will permit you to make informed decisions for your collection and its long-term preservation. For more information about the effects of RH and temperature on collections, please visit the CCI website.